It was a moment to say thank you, a chance to express gratitude for service and sacrifice that will never be forgotten.
And we want to show our commitment to the veterans because they had their commitment to the country and now their commitment to the company.
Dependable people, a large number of them veterans, have been part of Pratt Whitney's DNA for decades. And America's success in combat can be linked in part to the people and products of Pratt & Whitney.
Have you shown enough respect for veteran service?
This inaugural event held at the Hangar centered on just that, respect. Organized by the United Technologies Coalition for Veterans, or UTC for Vets, the group hopes the more than 2,400 Pratt & Whitney veterans feel valued for both their work and military contributions.
I think what veterans bring to this organization, or any organization for that matter, they bring a force of commitment. They're certainly well-educated. They understand the importance of doing the tough jobs and sticking with the tough jobs. And I think you saw that in a lot of the members that were there.
Dan Ward agrees with the general's perspective. He's a Marine Corps reservist, Pratt & Whitney employee, and president of the newly formed initiative.
I think it's a big deal in today's society. You know, being a veteran, there is a lot of recognition out there. But if you've served in the past few years, you may not hear it as often as you did before. So we want to keep up our appreciation of our veterans.
Matthew Bromberg, president of Pratt & Whitney's aftermarket unit, spent 5 years in the Navy.
There's a great history in the military, and veterans have that. And Pratt & Whitney and UTC, 90-year history, has a heritage, has a purpose, it has roots, it has foundation. And we want to just continue growing that and celebrating that. And that's what today is all about.
Respect was also shown to those we lost with the rededication of the World War II plaque. But the names on the wall and those that were here share a common bond, a love of country.
Countless veterans came up to me and said, this is the first time in my career, 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, where I had a recognition like this. And there was pride in their eyes and a quiver in their voice. And that's the rewarding part of the day.